What do you get when you multiply infinity by 2? Do you get an infinity twice as large as the original? But infinity is already infinite, as in it's not finite or limited, so how can you increase something that already doesn't have any limit in the first place? But at the same time, when you multiply something by 2, you obviously must be increasing its size, right? So which is it? So what I'm going to do here is explain how doubling infinity gives you an infinity that is exactly the same size as the original. Not sort of the same size or vaguely the same size, but the exact same mathematical size. There are mathematical proofs for this, but I'm going to give you an intuitive argument here so that hopefully you can understand in your gut why this is true. So let's start off with the number line. How many elements are there in the set of all positive numbers? Infinite, right? Now, instead of doubling it, I'm going to halve it. So I will remove exactly half the elements in this set. An easy way to do this is to remove all the odd numbers. So now we have just even numbers left, which is exactly half the numbers from the original set, right? Great. Okay, so let's compare the size of the original set to the new one with half the elements removed. You're probably looking at this and going, well, they're both technically infinite. This one has infinite elements, and this one also seems to have infinite elements, but clearly the original set with all the numbers is twice as big as the one with only the even numbers. So even though both are infinite in size, the first infinite is probably twice as big as the second one in some sense, right? Sure, that's a natural thing to think when you compare these sets, but I'm going to show you why that is incorrect. So let's just take a look at the first set with all the numbers. What I'm going to do now is go through this list and double every element in it. What does this give us? It's now 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, and so on all the way to infinity. That is, it's just the set of all the even numbers. But that's exactly the same set we had when we removed all the odd numbers from the original set. Not sort of the same set or vaguely the same set, but the exact same set. Every single number in this new set is present in the set of even numbers we obtained by removing all the odd numbers from the original set. By definition, doubling all whole numbers just gives you all the even numbers. That's what even numbers are. And that's precisely the set we obtained by removing all the odd numbers from the original set. Now, what's the size of the set of doubled whole numbers? Can it possibly be smaller than the set of whole numbers that we started off with? I mean, we didn't remove a single number from the original set, we just doubled all of them. So it has to have the same number of elements as the original, right? If we don't remove any element or add any element to a set, which we didn't do here, we simply doubled the values of each element in it, the total number of elements is obviously still the same. So this tells us that removing half the numbers, odd numbers in this case, from an infinite set of whole numbers just gives us a set which is identical, mathematically identical, to a set we get by doubling all the numbers in that set. And that just tells us that removing half the elements of an infinity gives us an infinity which is exactly the same size as the one that we started off with. Or going the other way, if we start off with an infinity and double it, we get an infinity exactly the same size as the one we started out with. So infinity times 2 is not a bigger infinity, it is the exact same infinity. So that answers the question I started off this video with. But it gets a bit more interesting, so just follow along here for a little while. So when working with the original set of whole numbers, I removed all the odd elements and simply ignored them. But now let's take a look at those odd numbers too. So the original set can be broken up into two sets, one of even numbers, the other made of all the odd numbers. So my question is, what is the size of the set of all the odd numbers? Isn't it the exact same size as the set of all the even numbers? Obviously it is, because for every even number, there's an odd number. In fact, we can make this even clearer by adding 1 to all the elements in the set of all odd numbers. That doesn't change the size of the set. We're not adding or removing any elements from it again, but it converts that set to be identical to the set of all the even numbers that we have right here. But, and here's the unintuitive part, the set of even numbers is the exact same size as the original set. So the set of odd numbers must also be the exact same size as the original set too. So what am I saying here? That I can take a set, split it into two equal halves, and each of the two parts are the same size as the original? Yes, that is what I'm saying here. But with one condition. only if the original set is infinite in size. That is why the title of this video references the perils of infinity, because these type of counterintuitive properties are possible when we play around with infinite spaces or sets containing infinite elements. In fact, we can keep splitting each subset of the original set into halves, and every half will have the same size as its parent set. And we can keep doing this an infinite number of times. So not only is 2 times infinity the exact same size as infinity, even infinity times infinity is the exact same size as infinity. So to answer the question in the title of my video, infinity squared is just infinity. Not a bigger infinity or a more numerous infinity in some sense, the exact same infinity. Now, if you're familiar with some higher level math, then this might ring a bell for you, because this option that allows for the manipulation of infinite sets is precisely what is postulated in the axiom of choice, which forms the C in the Z of C axiomatic system. And one of the results of applying the axiom of choice is the Banach-Tarski paradox, which allows the decomposition of a single sphere into 2 identical copies of the original sphere. This has been covered before on YouTube by Vsauce, but if that video didn't make too much sense to you, I hope this breakdown I did here using just whole numbers gives you an intuitive understanding of how it's possible to get double of what you started with for free. The key here is infinity. Once you throw that into the mix, your intuitive sense of size and quantity goes out the window, and you can start getting things out of nothing.